In this video, we're going to take a closer look at the conservation of momentum. Recall that momentum is a property of a body that is in motion. It's equal to the mass of the body times its velocity. We've seen that when objects interact with each other, the total momentum of the object remains constant, regardless of the nature of the forces acting between the objects. In other words, momentum is conserved. As an equation, the conservation of momentum says that the initial momentum of a system is equal to its final momentum. Here's an example of a problem in which the conservation of momentum can be used to calculate the final velocity of an object after an interaction with another object. Suppose a boater has reached the shore and is stepping out of his boat onto the land. The boater has a mass of 81 kilograms and was in a 65 kilogram boat. If he steps out of the boat with a velocity of 2.3 meters per second towards the shore, what is the final velocity of the boat? The first thing we want to do is set up a data table that clearly shows the information that is given to us and what we're trying to solve for. M sub 1, which will refer to the mass of the boater, is equal to 81 kilograms. V sub 1i, which is the initial velocity of the man, is going to be 0 because he is initially at rest in the boat. The final velocity of the man, V sub 1f, is going to be equal to 2.3 meters per second towards the shore because that is the final velocity of the boater as he steps onto the shore. The mass of the boat, M sub 2, is equal to 65 kilograms. The boat's initial velocity, V sub 2i, is equal to 0 since the boat is also initially at rest. We want to solve for the boat's final velocity, V sub 2f. Since the man and the boat are both initially at rest, both initial velocities will be 0. Therefore, the total initial momentum of the system is also equal to 0. Since momentum has to be conserved, the final momentum of the system must also be equal to 0. We can write that out as m sub 1 times v sub 1f plus m sub 2 times v sub 2f is equal to 0. We can move m sub 2 times v sub 2f to the other side of the equation and see that m sub 1 times v sub 1f equals negative m sub 2 times v sub 2f. Now all we need to do is rearrange the equation to solve for the final velocity of the boat. We divide both sides by m2 and see that it is equal to negative m sub 1 times v sub 1f divided by m sub 2. We plug in 81 kilograms for m sub 1, 2.3 meters per second for v sub 1f, and 65 kilograms for m sub 2, and find that the final velocity of the boat is negative 2.9 meters per second, or 2.9 meters per second away from the shore. Here's another example of a problem in which conservation momentum is used to find the answer. If a 41 kilogram student is on ice skates, holding a 23 kilogram exercise ball, and then the student throws the ball horizontally, causing the student to move backwards at 3.4 meters per second, what would be the final velocity of the ball? The first thing we want to do is create a data table that lists everything that we're given along with what we're solving for. The mass of the student, which we will call M sub 1, is 41 kilograms. The mass of the exercise ball, which we will call M sub 2, is 23 kilograms. Initially, both the student and the ball have a velocity of 0 before the ball is thrown. So this will be a similar setup to the last problem, in which we know the final momentum must be 0 since the initial momentum is 0. We can write that out as m sub 1 times v sub 1f plus m sub 2 times v sub 2f equals 0. We want to solve for v sub 2f, the final velocity of the ball. To do that, we'll rearrange this equation by subtracting m sub 1 v sub 1f from both sides, and then dividing both sides by m sub 2, the mass of the ball. Plugging our values into the equation and solving, we find that the final velocity of the ball must be 6.1 meters per second after rounding to two significant figures. The direction of the velocity vector would be in the opposite direction of the student that is gliding after throwing the ball. Now here's one for you to try. A soccer player places a 74 kilogram automatic soccer ball throwing machine on a frictionless surface and gives it a push so it moves at 1 meter per second to the left. While it is sliding, the machine fires a 0.43-kilogram soccer ball horizontally with a velocity of 28 meters per second to the right. What is the final velocity of the machine? Take a moment, press pause, and try it for yourself. Did you get negative 1.2 meters per second? If so, great work. If not, let's take a look at how we got that answer. As always, we want to construct a data table showing all the data that's given along with what we're solving for. The mass of the soccer ball machine, m sub m, is 74 kilograms. The initial velocity of the machine and the soccer ball is 1 meter per second to the left in the negative x direction. We are solving for the final velocity of the machine, which we will designate as v sub mf. The mass of the soccer ball we will designate as m sub s, which is 0.43 kilograms. The final velocity of the soccer ball, v sub sf, is 28 meters per second. Starting with the law of momentum conservation, in this case the initial momentum of our system is not zero. Both the machine and the soccer ball are initially moving at negative 1 meter per second. We want to solve for the final velocity of the machine. To do that, let's rearrange this equation. First, we subtract the final momentum of the soccer ball from both sides, and then we divide both sides by the machine's mass. We now see that the final velocity of the machine equals the mass of the machine times its initial velocity, plus the mass of the soccer ball times its initial velocity, minus the soccer ball's mass times its final velocity, all divided by the mass of the machine. Plugging in all our numbers from the data table, we find that the final velocity of the machine is negative 1.2 meters per second, or 1.2 meters per second to the left in the negative direction. That's a closer look at conservation of momentum. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.